Hi guys, so this time we have come with a new content, not about particularly about stock trading, but trading in general, about finance in general. So today I have my friend Prashur with me. He is not any big stock trader or nothing like that. He is also a learner. He has been trading for around 2 years now, and he has some insights to share with you all, some valuable experience which might be helpful for upcoming traders. His experience will be very useful to us, so that we don't make mistakes in our early days. So hi Prashur, so can you tell about
hi Santosh.
Yeah, so how are
you? Definitely, yeah. I'm good, Santosh. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. So can you tell about yourself? What do you do?
Yeah, so hi, Santosh. Thanks for having me here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been trading from past 2 years. Majorly, the first mistake I did was I directly jumped into intraday trading.
Okay.
Intraday trading means where you buy and sell the stocks in the same day on the basis of leverage.
Okay.
Where most of the brokers offer 5x, 10x leverage.
Okay.
That is, for example, if you have 10,000, you can trade up to 1 lakh. So that is the meaning of leverage, where you get 10x margin.
Okay.
So that is intraday trading. So that was the first mistake I did. I directly jumped into intraday trading by having some basic technical knowledge, by following trend line, support, resistance. But when I started, I didn't follow anything like risk management, money management, how much should be my loss, how much should be my profit. And then during my first year of learning, got to know about swing trading. I felt that swing trading is much more secure than intraday, where the possibility of making loss is very much less in swing trading. In intraday, what you have to do is, whether it's profit or loss, you have to, at the end of the day, you have to book it, whether it's profit or loss, and you have to pay the brokerage for it. But in swing trading, it's not the case. If you hold it for some weeks and then you sell, you will not be paying any extra brokerage. So basically, 90% of the Indians, as we know that, they lose money in stock market. It's because many people, they invest just randomly. They have money and they just invest. They don't define their risk. They think it's a gambling. So there's a lot of misconception among people that stock market is a gambling.
Yeah.
But that's not the case. It's like a business actually,
yeah,
where you run a business having a profit of around 20%, 25%. That you can decide how much target you want to have. As many shopkeepers run their business, they have a defined profit of 15%, 20%. So stock market is also like that. Many people also trade in futures and options. That is, like, they don't have knowledge about that and they just have money and invest in that. That causes the major loss. They also do intraday in that. So that's why majorly they make losses, and they just quit their journey then. They feel that it's gambling and it's not possible to make money. But it's not like that. I myself have been improving myself. I can see that if you trade with proper knowledge, proper discipline, if you have proper risk management, proper money management, it's actually basically about all your psychology. It's basically the trading is all about psychology. 80% it's about psychology. For example, if you have 1 lakh rupees, you don't have to invest that 1 lakh in a single stock. Instead, you can invest 30,000 or 25,000 in each stock, so that you can four different stocks. For example, if you define your risk as 5%, 5% of 25,000 is around 1,250 rupees.
Yeah.
In swing trading, you have a potential where market can reward you four times of your risk. So four times of your risk, in the sense, if your risk is 1,250, your profit can be 1,250 into the four times,
which is 5,000.
Yeah, 5,000. Yeah, exactly. If you're a beginner,
yeah,
you should start with swing trading. So that's my experience, because I jumped directly into intraday and I have wiped off my account many times.
Okay.
So please don't do intraday. Don't use leverage and always trade in cash market, equity market. I would suggest that. Okay. In the beginning,
not in commodities or something.
Not in commodities. So only you can trade with you can start with equity cash market. This all I'm explaining on the basis that you have to learn technical analysis first. So that is very important for swing trading. It's actually a skill that can be that anyone can master yeah. it. Even a 10th standard guy, a 10th standard student or a 11th standard student, he can also learn it. These are very basic things. So how people make mistakes is, so for example, if your buy price is around 105, right? And your stop loss is 90. So first of all, your risk is 1250 per trade, right? Your stop loss is 90 and your entry price is 105, means 15 rupees. Your risk is 15 rupees. So how should be your position sizing? It should be 1250 divided by the 15 rupees. That much quantity you have to trade as per your 1250 rupees risk. What people do is they just buy randomly. Don't buy for 25,000. They buy for 40,000, 50,000.
Okay. Yeah.
And they don't define their risk. They don't define their position sizing. So many people make mistakes. They don't follow their rules.
Mm.
So you have to stick on your rules first.
Yeah.
Then the second common mistake what they do is, for example, if they buy at the price of 105.
Okay.
Right. It's not necessary that the next day that stock will go to 110. It's not necessary that your stock will be in profit zone.
Yeah.
The next day. Instead, what can do the stock can do is, if you have bought at the price of 105, it can come down to 97, 96, 95. Yeah, you have defined your stop loss as 90 rupees, right?
Yeah.
So many people they get scared.
Mm-mm-mm.
So what they do is they quit at 95, 96, and they book their loss. Yeah, they're not ready to wait to see their trade going in the profit zone.
Mm.
So,
but there is also a case like, see, when you buy it at 105, for around 1 to 2 weeks, it's around hovering around 92, 93. Then suddenly at one point the next day, it goes around 89 or 87. But that time also you have hopes on that stock. But around after 2-3 days, it shoots up and it goes over maybe say 107 or 110 the next few weeks. So here, it's you don't know where to quit, right? It's almost like it's consolidating around in that price range. So when do you know you have to quit?
Yeah, so at this point your psychology comes in.
Okay.
Right, so what happens is when the stock comes at 90, you have defined your stop loss at 90 rupees.
Yeah,
but most of the people, they don't exit at 90 rupees.
Okay.
They still have hope that it will cross 105. It will. They think that when it will come to 105, I will quit.
Okay.
I will exit at cost and I will save my loss.
Okay.
So what happens is when the stock is trading near 90, then it goes to 80, then it goes to 70. People still don't book their loss. Most of the times.
Okay.
So this is all because of psychology. This is all because of your emotions, psychology. You get that fear of that you're losing money. You still have hope that you will when it will come to 105, you will exit at cost. But you have to exit at 90.
Mm-mm.
So you have to just stick on to your rules. You have to exit at 90. If it again crosses 105.
Okay.
See, there's always whenever the stock hits the stop loss and again it tries to break your entry price.
Okay.
That is 105.
Okay.
Then that momentum will be more powerful than the first one. Yeah.
Yeah.
So what I will do is I will, if in case it, in my stop loss hits,
yeah,
I lose 1250.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
But if it tries to cross my entry price, that is 105.
Yeah.
I will enter with double quantity.
Yeah.
So most of the time it's obvious that whenever the stock crosses the entry price after hitting the stop loss again,
yeah,
it will have more momentum than the first one.
Yeah. But this contradicts your first statement. You told strictly that when it hits the stop loss, you have to sell, like you don't have to keep hope and you have to sell that point. But here it's again retracing and it's going again with more momentum. But this time, so what you mean to say is you have to wait for some time. For the first time, when you see it again retracing upwards, then you have to, you know, double your hope and put more and wait for the best. So that is what you're saying, right?
Yeah, so when you stop loss, you should accept your loss. You should book your loss.
But you told the momentum will go, you know, the momentum will be more for the next retrace, right? So see, you bought it at 105, then it's going to 90, but you again see a retrace in again few two three days, and it's again starting to increase. But what if people sell at 90 and for the in the next 2-3 days they see again it has increased, and they have the fear of missing out, they feel bad. So what do you do?
See, actually, yeah, this is what all about experience. I am also in my learning phase now. See, it has happened with me also that my stop loss has hit, and whenever the stock has tried to cross the entry price, it has gone with double momentum, but still I didn't buy that. I also had that fear of losing again. So most of the time it has happened with me, but majority I have seen such trades where when the stock tries to cross the entry price, the second time it will go with it will be more powerful than the first one. Recently it has happened with me, and in the past few months I have took more risk, and I have traded with double quantity, and I have also achieved good targets.
Okay, so I
see, in swing trading you have very good accuracy as well. In intraday trading your accuracy can be 50% or 70%. Not 70% exactly, 60% accuracy. But in swing trading, you have very good accuracy.
Mm-hmm.
Your probability of hitting your stop loss is like very minimal. And trade with the money with which you can afford to lose. So I would recommend a beginner to start with around 10,000, 15,000.
Okay.
And invest in different stocks. See, trading is all about psychology. 80% is psychology. Skill is, you can easily master it. So you just first make your set of rules, define your strategy, define your risk according to which you have to select your position sizing, like how much stocks you should buy. So this should be the procedure which you should follow. When I started during my initial days, I never used to follow all this. My risk was not defined. My how much profits I should book, it was this was all not defined. I am also in my learning phase. I am also trying to improve myself.
Yeah.
It's all about assessing yourself.
Yeah, definitely. So yeah, this episode has been great. Thanks for sharing your insights. And
thank you, Santosh.
So that's it for today, guys.
See you guys in the next episode. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.